Hare Krishna, welcome to Srimad Bhagavatam. Hare Krishna, Om Namah Shivaya, Jai Jagannath. Today I am reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 2nd Chapter, 23rd Sloka. This sloka discusses that Lord Vishnu is the deity of sattva, goodness. Lord Brahma is the deity of passion. And Lord passion is Rajas, and Lord Shiva is the deity of ignorance, Tamas. The sloka is Sattvam Rajas Tama Iti Prakruti Gunas Tai Yukta Para Purusha Eka Ihasya Dhate Siti Adaye Hari Virinchi Hareti Samnya Shreyam Sritatra Khalau Sattva Tano Runam Syuhu. The transcendental person of Godhead, Krishna, is indirectly associated with the three modes of material nature, namely passion, goodness, and ignorance. And just for the material world's creation, maintenance, and destruction, he accepts the three qualitative forms of Brahma, Vishnu and Siva. Of these three, all human beings can derive ultimate benefit from Vishnu, the form of quality of goodness. You see, in Hindu circles, there is this misconception that all gods are same. Krishna, Lord Vishnu, Lord Brahma, and Lord Shiva, they are all the same. Srimad Bhagavatam is directly contradicting that. There is also the misconception in Hinduism that you can pray to any god and achieve whatever benediction which you like. That is also contradicted by this sloka. Please recognize that Lord Vishnu, Lord Shiva, and Lord Brahma are three different personalities. They are not the same. I am different from you. Similarly, Lord Vishnu, Lord Brahma, and Lord Shiva are different from you. If they are different, please ask yourself whom you would like to be devoted to. I'll read the purport of Srila Prabhupada to this in English. Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 2nd Chapter, 23rd Sloka. That Lord Krishna, by his plenary parts, should be rendered devotional service as explained above, is confirmed by this statement. Lord Krishna and all his plenary parts are Vishnu Tattva, or the Lordship of Godhead. From Krishna, the next manifestation is Baladeva, then Sankarsana, then Narayana, then second Sankarsana, then the Vishnu Purusha Avataras. The Vishnu or deity of quality of goodness in the material world is the Purusha Avatara known as Kshirodakasai Vishnu or Paramatma. I think Kshirodakasai Vishnu is what they call Mahavishnu in Sri Sampradaya, in Ramanuja Sampradaya. Brahma is the deity of Rajas, and Rajas is passion, and Shiva is the deity of ignorance, Tamas. Vishnu, Brahma, and Shiva are the three departmental heads of the three qualities of this material world. Creation is made possible by the goodness of Lord Vishnu. When it requires to be destroyed, Lord Shiva does it by his Tandavanutya. The materialists and the foolish human beings worship Brahma and Shiva respectively. Srila Prabhupada is very heavy, yeah? But the pure transcendentalists worship the form of goodness, Lord Vishnu, in his various forms. Lord Vishnu is manifested by his millions and billions of integrated forms and separated forms. The integrated forms are called Godhead. The separated forms are called the living entities or jivas. both the jivas and Godhead have their original spiritual forms. Jivas are sometimes subjected to the control of material energy, but the Vishnu forms are always controllers of this energy. The Vishnu appears in the material world. When Vishnu appears in the material world, he comes to deliver conditioned living beings who are under the material energy. Such living beings appear in the world with intentions of being lords, and thus they become entrapped by the modes of nature. Anyway, it's a long purport. You can read it online on the internet at vedabase.com. First canto, second chapter, 23rd sloka. So here in this sloka, it is clearly said that Lord Shiva is the deity of ignorance, deity of tamas, deity of ignorance. Now, if you are a Lord Shiva worshipper, and if you are devoted Lord Shiva, that's cool. Thank you for your devotion. Please develop your devotion to Lord Shiva. But just understand scripturally. What is the biggest benediction which Lord Shiva can give you? Love of God, love of Krishna. That is the best benediction which Lord Shiva can give you. Unfortunately, we are worshipping Lord Shiva for very, very minor things. Give me a nice wife. Give me money. Money is nice. It's important. Or, you know, give me the power to destroy my enemy. All these things are temporary. The best benediction you can ask Lord Shiva is love of God and love of Krishna. The way the Gopikas were devoted to Krishna. If you read Srimad Bhagavatam, it is discussed how the Gopikas used to do Katyayani Vrat so that they can get Krishna as their husband. Actually, even in Bhagavad Gita, there are a few slokas which discusses devotion to other gods. Firstly, there is a difference between gods and Supreme Personality of Godhead. That's why in ISKCON we refer to gods as demigods. So I'll read from the purport again. Lord Vishnu is worshipped by devotional service only. If anyone has to continue prison life in the material world, he may ask for relative facilities for temporary relief from the different demigods like Siva, Brahma, Indra and Varuna. No demigod, that is Lord Shiva, Lord Brahma, Indra and Varuna, however, can release imprisoned living being from the conditioned life of material existence. This can be done only by Vishnu. Therefore, the ultimate benefit may be derived from Vishnu, the Personality of Godhead. Actually, the same principle is also discussed in Bhagavad Gita, 27th chapter, 20th and 21st slokas. Kamaistaistai hrutagnana prapadyante anya devata tam tam niyamam astaya prakrutya niyataya svaya. Those whose intelligence is stolen by material desires surrender unto demigods and follow the particular rules and regulations of worship according to their own nature. The 21st sloka is Yo yau yo yo yam yam tanum bhakta sreddaya chitum icchati tasya tasya achalam sreddham tam eva vidhami aham vidadhami aham. Krishna is in everyone's super soul. As soon as one desires to worship some demigod, Krishna makes his faith steady so that he can devote himself to that particular deity. If you want to worship Lord Shiva, that's cool, that's awesome, thank you. Please try to understand that it is by the mercy of Lord Krishna that you are able to worship Lord Shiva. Similarly, Vaishnavas do worship Lord Krishna because of the mercy of Lord Shiva. Because Lord Shiva, he is the foremost Vaishnava. Vaishnavanam yathashambho. Anyway, The biggest benediction you can ask for God is love of God. Everything else is temporary. Ask God for love of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, love of Srimad Bhagavatam, love of meditation, love of chanting the names of God, and love of God. Please invest in yourself. Please read Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam for 10 minutes a day. Please do meditation for 10 minutes a day. Maybe one day you'll become like my friends and take up meditation for 2 hours a day. I do meditation for around 2 hours a day. 16 malas. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Let us inundate the world with love of God. That is the biggest benediction which Lord Shiva can give. Thank you. Hare Krishna.